Hello, and welcome to this short video on the world of today photographic art and ICM abstract images. My name is David Day, and I am an internationally recognized innovator in abstract and textual camera movement techniques that have resulted in many unique and fascinating images that you will soon see. 3 years ago, I abandoned traditional photography to develop techniques that have resulted in distinctly unique works of photographic art. In 2023, after winning several category, Judges' Choice, and Best in Show competitions, I became an artist in residence at the Northern Light Gallery in Albuquerque, New Mexico. Being from Hendersonville, North Carolina, I am represented locally by Art Mob Studios and Gallery of Fine Art. I have written 3 books and produced 5 videos on my work to help other ICM photographers develop their own abstract ICM visions. One of my books, available on Amazon, peaked at number 2 on the Individual Artist's bestseller list. In addition to my own photographic journey, I provide both one-on-one and classroom instruction to others who are interested in furthering this form of image production. My complete works are available at ddayicmart.com, and it would be very helpful to me if you would consider subscribing to my website. It's free, and with the images to follow, I hope to earn your continued interest in my work through subscription. My artist statement is this: dreams often shift abruptly from one interactive experience to another in unrelated yet seemingly connected ways. My work attempts to capture these experiences and provide opportunities for the viewer to make connections that would not otherwise be considered outside of lucid dream events. Advances in gas mask technology is representative of my transition from single subjects to multi-subject scenes, and I'll explain that in a moment. So what is ICM art anyhow? First and foremost, it is not art that has been generated by artificial intelligence or digital algorithm means. All of the art you see in this video was produced by moving my camera in a very precise manner during long exposures of anywhere from 1/2 to 5 seconds. Tendonitis is a good example of this technique that employs a glass vase, plastic bags, and tissue paper in the scene. It was a 1 1/2 second exposure using 2 distinct camera movements. The process is quite involved, and it typically takes me around 5,000 exposures to generate the results I am trying to achieve with any given photograph. Before I began the studio ICM abstraction movement, almost all ICM photography was natural, environment-based subject matter. I took those techniques, adapted them to the studio with modification required for close-up work to produce almost all of the images appearing in this video. In short, this is what I do. I take common throwaway items like plastic bags, tissue paper, strings, weeds, and glass and apply my ICM techniques to them to make something beautiful out of the mundane. I also manage the Hendo One Gallery for the purpose of promoting other ICM artists. You can learn more about that on my website. For your viewing pleasure, I have configured the gallery today to show works representative of my vision. Here we are in the waiting area of the Hendo One Gallery. I have a QR code on the wall here so you can quickly and easily access my website. Just hold your mobile phone camera up to this image and follow the web address that pops up in the camera window. In this first set of images, we see some results of my early ICM experiments that involved single subjects with strategic lighting to make them pop upon application of camera movement to the static scenes. Let's take a closer look at each of these. Image number 2621 is a single blue plastic-coated copper wire suspended in a dark box and lit from the side with a 5-watt lamp. The bends in the wire created highlights and shadows on the wire that resulted in a striated effect. My ICM journey began quite by accident while applying ICM techniques to several wires on my shop workbench one day when I returned home from a photo assignment. Had it not been for a random success in my shop, I doubt I would have ever started exploration of ICM that resulted in the images seen here today. Maple leaf is another one of my very early ICM images. After developing the process that resulted in good wire photographs, I started to apply the techniques to parts of plants with very good results. As far as ICM photographs of plant parts is concerned, Fred and Ginger is one of my all-time favorites. One day while weeding my flower garden, I collected an interesting weed stem that had a small hat of flowers on top of it. With side lightings, I produced this image from that single stem. Doesn't it just remind you of Ginger Rogers and Fred Astaire dancing? Here is an image titled Blossom. This is an important image to me because it marked my abandonment of single subject images in favor of multi-element images. This one incorporates a green ribbon, some blue tissue paper, and a bamboo leaf. With a long exposure rotational movement of the camera, I achieved this result, and the success launched me into exploration of multi-element scenes, which continues to this day. Two bowls is a significant image in my ICM journey. This image is an orange plastic flex drinking straw with a small piece of red tissue paper attached to it. Just for the fun of it, I submitted this image to a still life competition and was shocked when I won all three categories available in the competition. Several photographers challenged the judges on the win, but after pointing out that the rules said nothing about restricting camera movement, my award was upheld. They must have really liked the idea because it was this image that resulted in an invitation to be the artist in residence at a gallery in Albuquerque. Today, I am very focused on ICM art that contains pareidolic elements, that is, abstract images that play games with the mind when one tries to determine what they are. Here are some of my favorite pareidolias for which I have received recognition awards. Here is an image I recently produced called Bouncing a Ball. Doesn't this remind you of someone with blue and pink hair with bracelets on their arm bouncing a ball? It is nothing more than a combination of tissue paper, a glass jar, and a wooden stick to which ICM techniques have been applied. Three Amigos is a simple form of pareidolia. It reminds me of three rotund and happy men standing together, waiting for something to happen, maybe a bus or train to arrive. It's nothing more than a single, partially folded plastic bag with LED backlighting, to which intermittent camera movements have been applied. The Punishment of Sisyphus is an unusual image that reminds me of Greek mythology. Sisyphus was a lesser Greek god who fell out of favor with his superiors, and his punishment was to spend eternity rolling a stone uphill. Look how the relationship of the glass jar movement to the orange plastic bag creates tension that just looks painful. The Royal Proclamation is simply an amusing image to me. It looks like some sort of court official wearing a big hat with feathers pointing to a passage in a proclamation as he reads it out loud to the ruler's subjects. I am also now producing a limited number of triptychs. This is one called Celebration. It is at present an artist proof that I am working on for a monochrome competition in New York City a few months from now. In addition to the images we have explored today, I have produced many images for you to look at on my website. In addition to my standard gallery, I do commission work for collectors who are looking for investment quality work that is certified to be one of a kind. Here we are back in the foyer, and here I have included a number of my social media image outlets and would be thrilled if you started following my work. Also, I would be very appreciative if you would go to my website and click the subscribe button and subscribe to my monthly newsletter. It will keep you up to date on my recent works as well as a number of other benefits I provide to customers who follow me. I really do appreciate the time you've taken to watch my video today, and for the many people who have supported my work, my sincerest thanks.